playing cricket and becoming part of a team basically saved my life. I realised there were things that I could still do and I could do them well. Life didn't end, it just changed.
46-year-old Julie sleeps and breathes cricket, but it wasn't always her first love.
I loved being a hairdresser and just making women feel special, giving them the self-confidence that I think every woman likes.
But when she was just 31, her passion was abruptly cut short.
I woke up one morning and had trouble driving my kids to school. There was no eye infection, there was nothing. And I saw someone the next morning and was declared legally blind.
She was diagnosed with retinitis pigmentosa, a genetic condition that caused cells in her eyes to degenerate.
I had been told that that would happen much later in life. It was definitely a huge shock. Suddenly having to ask for help was a big struggle.
While navigating a new way of life, Julie was introduced to the sport of blind cricket.
The first time that I played, I was a little bit overwhelmed. You know, to see everyone out there running around and giving it a go, I went, yeah, these guys are living well. I want to keep doing this. They're out there, they're having fun.
Taking to the field quickly became her salvation.
When I'm out there playing cricket, I feel free, feel empowered, and I feel strong and that I can do anything.
You see a very determined person. Cricket has given Julie belief in herself, purpose for achieving goals that she's probably had deep down in herself that she's wanted to achieve.
Blind cricket was developed by two factory workers in Melbourne 100 years ago using rocks and a tin can. And today it's played around the world using a modified ball with bearings. Each team is made up of four totally blind players and seven with varying degrees of vision impairment.
Keeper!
10, 10, 10.
Batter ready?
Yes.
Play.
There is a lot more involved with the sound. We do a lot of talking in the field, letting people know where we are. So communication, lots of communication.
No. I first started playing blind cricket through primary school. I'm better at bowling than batting, but I try my hardest to be good at everything.
16-year-old Addie has cone dystrophy, which means her vision is not only blurry, but she can't see colour and has an extreme sensitivity to light.
It takes me probably a couple minutes at the start of any game to adjust to what the weather might be like during that day. So if it's a really glary day, I'll probably won't be able to see as much.
Even as a 12-year-old, Addie dreamt that one day Australia might have its own all-female team.
So I was always thinking about, would there be any chance that I could play with, just girls?
And her campaign was successful. Just 10 months after forming, 14 girls travelled to the UK to compete in the World Blind Games.
This was my first overseas tournament for the sport. Going and opening the bowling for Australia and taking that second and thinking, oh, I'm really here, I've really made it this far.
With Julie as captain, the girls took home silver.
In the final, walking out onto Edgbaston, it was really indescribable stepping out onto such an amazing world stage. We're not that different from the regular person. We've just got our own special qualities about us.
Without cricket, I think I'd feel a bit lost. I had never played a sport growing up, and to suddenly be given the baggy green, you know, if we put our minds to it, we can do it. It's a great example for my children who have every chance that they're going to end up with retinitis pigmentosa as well, that you can go out there and you can do it and you can still be somebody.
Amazing. Incredible. And the type of ball they use as well, the plastic ball that rattles yeah. when it moves as well, because obviously they have to rely so much on hearing.
On the hearing, amazing. Yeah. It's a great example of how sport allows you to find your tribe. So,
yes.
You know, it's such a leveller, but it also creates great opportunity, and it's how, you know, people like Julie and Addie have found their tribe but have also found their passion. It's such a great story.
Yeah. I didn't know there's also blind tennis, cricket and golf.
Is there?
Netball? Yeah. Is there any netball?
Amazing.
Yeah, I don't know.
I'll look into that one. Amazing.